President McPhee, thank you for this invitation. I really am honored to be able to participate in such a momentous day. And I do want to say to the graduates, thank you for allowing me to share in your day. When I graduated from college, I was unable to attend my graduation ceremony. So as each of you walks across this stage, I'll be enjoying that moment vicariously. So thanks to you all. You know, as I look out here today at the faculty, family, friends, and the mentors, and of course, the accomplished class, Blue Raider class of 2023. I remember these moments as a graduate when I finally completed that college education, as a parent, four of our family members, Allison, Michael, Sarah, and David were graduates of this university. And as a teacher and as a mentor, I remember those moments and remember the anticipation, the dreams, the excitement, and the uncertainty of the future that is encapsulated in these moments. So today I wanted to begin by assuring you that the future is bright for you. If you make the effort and seize the opportunity has never been greater right here at home in Middle Tennessee than it is right now. The climate is ripe for graduates to quickly hone their skills and advance into leadership and management early in their career. Now, along the way, we accumulate mentors, some we know and meet, and some we just observe from afar. One of those mentors for me was a general of the Army and a president of the United States, Dwight Eisenhower. And one of those unforgettable lessons that I carried forward in my life when I heard this from him was, he made a comment where he said, "In preparing for battle, I have always found that plans are useless, but planning is indispensable. Plans are useless, but planning is indispensable." His message: embrace the power of flexibility and adaptability. You know, life, as many of you have already learned, particularly during the pandemic, rarely goes according to plan. When I graduated college, I set my sights on running for elected office. But that plan and those aspirations transformed as unexpected opportunities emerged. Trusting my instincts to modify my plan led to the realization of those unforeseen benefits and a path for me that was more satisfying and fulfilling. Flexibility allows us to enter situations thinking we know the outcome we want, only to leave with the outcome we actually need. So embrace the unexpected. The most fulfilling opportunities often come from the least expected places. And then secondly, invest in your community. The Middle Tennessee region is a testament to the power of intentional investment in community. It's a place that gives you what you need if you invest yourself. The collaboration of others who have preceded you in this region have created a prosperous community. As an example, the average household income in this region last year grew by $7,500 in 1 year, the average per household. This type of growth and this type of opportunity doesn't exist in any other parts of the nation. The opportunity to hit the ground running right here in Middle Tennessee, making more money with a higher quality of life than your peers around the nation, that is a real opportunity right here. And I can promise you that there's a company willing to compete for your expertise. There are presently 55,000 job openings in this region. If you're a nurse looking for a job, there are 2,500 positions with an average starting wage of $59,000. If you're a computer scientist or software engineer looking to start your career, There are 1,400 positions with an average starting wage of $92,000 a year. And recently, the Brookings Institution released a study that highlighted Nashville as the nation's fastest growing hubs for tech jobs. Now, for those of you in other thriving verticals like construction, concrete management, agribusiness, media, the possibilities are just as great. There's not only competition for each of you in the workforce, but also opportunity for once-in-a-lifetime career growth. So how do you take things from learning to action? Well, your journey through this university has taught you how to finish. That's an important lesson. You've demonstrated the perseverance, you've experienced the joy, you've surmounted the challenges, and made discoveries and evolved to get you to this graduation. You're not the person you were when you first began here. Today is a celebration of the scholars and doers that you've become, but today also marks the beginning of a new phase where your learning transforms into action. MTSU has equipped you with knowledge and skills. Now it's time to apply those skills. But never underestimate the power of what you've learned here, who you've learned it from, and the way you've learned it. There are lessons in all of that experience. No matter how prepared you are, though, there is no plan that survives the whims of life, as we've seen. As Mike Tyson, another mentor of mine, put it, everyone has a plan until they get punched in the mouth. Life is going to throw unexpected challenges at you, but it's in those moments that resilience is built. Believe in yourself and the investment made in you. Be prepared to take risks. And when faced with adversity, remember, it's not the fall that defines you, but how you get back up. Knowledge is your foundation. Planning is your roadmap. Organization brings resources together. Action is your engine, and evaluation is your compass. So there's one final mentor quote I'd like to share with you, and it deals with courage, confidence, and the strength of conviction. And it was spoken by Teddy Roosevelt decades ago. If you happen to look this up, you'll see it listed under the man in the arena. I'm going to read it as he spoke it. Teddy Roosevelt said, "It's not the critic who counts. Not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes up short again and again, because there is no effort without error or shortcoming. But that person who knows the great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows, in the end, the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least knows he failed daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who knew neither victory nor defeat. In every stage of your life, if you live it to the fullest, you're going to find yourself being that person in the arena. And being in the arena can be a lonely place. You'll face challenge and doubt from within and from those around you. And they will challenge you on what you know to be true. Building great things often comes with the risk of criticism. Pursue those dreams with courage, conviction, knowing the path to success is often lined with doubters. Prove those doubters wrong, not with words, but with your actions and achievements. And so finally, to the parents and the families who have provided that unwavering support and that love that's been so crucial to the success of these graduates, your role cannot be overstated, and that role continues today. Your encouragement has been the wind beneath their wings, and as you watch them soar, take pride in knowing that you've been their home base, their sanctuary, and their guiding star. And to the faculty and staff of MTSU, your tireless dedication to teaching, to mentoring, and inspiring those students has crafted the leaders we see before us. Your impact extends far beyond the walls of the classroom and carries them forward and into their future lives. So finally, to the class of 23, as you step forward, remember these lessons. If you remember nothing else, remember, be bold, be inquisitive, and most importantly, have faith in yourself and in the value of the community that stands behind you. Thank you, and go Blue Raiders.